Well, after the storming success of Danny Kvyat in the previous episode in Singapore, we've now got a bit of a dilemma on our hands. Do we let him go, or do we sign Daniel Ricciardo? Yeah, g'day. Welcome to Season 2, Episode 23 of Race to the Top. I'm Ian, and in today's episode, we have got just over 2 weeks to Japan, the Yokohama GP. We'll talk about that in a little bit. But of course, we do have something quite interesting that's more than likely going to happen, which is Daniel Ricciardo could well be signing for Toro Rosso in this season. But let's talk about Danny Kvyat's crash. Where does the fault lie? Well, he didn't crash. So, I don't really know how to answer that. Yeah, I'll just blame him. I'll just blame myself. That doesn't make any sense. That's obviously a bug, because it was Pierre Gasly who stuffed up. Which, funnily enough, really annoys me, because I don't really know what to do. Every single episode, I've been chopping and changing about who's good and who's not. 1 minute it's, oh, you know, it's Pierre Gasly that's the problem, and then the next episode, oh, no, it's Kvyat that's the problem, and chopping and changing. But this is the news we were looking for. Daniel Ricciardo has signed, or has agreed, I should say, to the contract that we offered him. Now, what I was thinking of doing was maybe getting rid of this guy. Not that. The reserve driver, Sean Galail? Galail? Indonesian guy, I believe. I think that's the Indonesian flag, isn't it? Can we hover over and it tells you? No, it doesn't. But that's what I was thinking. I was thinking of getting rid of him and then demoting Gasly to reserve driver, and then bringing in Daniel Ricciardo. That's what I was thinking of doing. So, it's going to happen. We're going to sign Daniel Ricciardo. He's going to cost us a little bit of money, because we're looking at nearly $800,000 a race, which is obviously a lot more than what these guys are on. But it just makes real sense that we're going to have a pretty decent car next year. So, let's go for it. So, we're going to get rid of the 20-year-old Sean Galail. Let's make that happen. Yeah, it's going to cost us a fair chunk of money, but it is worth it. Promote to reserve driver. No, we don't want to promote to reserve driver. You need to select a driver to replace. We're going to replace Pierre Gasly. So Daniel Ricciardo is our number one driver now, which is quite an interesting proposition. I mean, not particularly realistic, is it? But I'm not really too worried about realism in this, because I just want to try and win the damn thing. But let's worry about that in a bit. I'm so far ahead of myself. We do have to worry about our pit crew, first of all, because we had another stuff-up. And this one, it was Della Fogli. So let's have a look, see if there's anyone that's worth hiring. And there's not. So, I mean, we could bring in 40, but terrible at everything. We'll reject that one, reject that one, reject that one. So now we need to start looking at bringing in some fresh blood, don't we? It's getting a bit silly here. Di Balsamo, yeah, you can come in. And we need to get Candido out as well. Let's do that. Who else needs who's in dire need of a break? 0.1, there you go. Balladinelli, you can come in there. 1.9. Oh man, there's so many stuff ups here. Yeah, look. Cipollini, you can come in there. So the highest is 1.2. That'll do. We haven't got anyone else to scout, do we? Oh, we're still scouting a couple. We'll worry about them later. We've also got a couple of sponsor offers. So again, what I'm thinking of doing, let's just take the fixed pay. Oris, there you go, 329,000 per race. That sort of makes sense. I don't want to go for any target positions. And what about this one? Upfront payment, 400,000. We'll just have to take that one. That's not a lot of money, is it? But every little bit helps. Let's keep going. So now that we've got Daniel Ricciardo, we kind of have to be quite careful with the rest of our finances for the rest of the year. As you can see, we've just taken a little dip because of it. If we go and have a quick look at improving parts, so deceleration and the suspension is crucial here. But as you can see, there's not really much more to be done. We can improve both of them. And deceleration, there's not really much more to do here either. So what we'll do is we'll just go 20 on that one. And you know what? Let's do a little bit of the rear wing just to improve the reliability. That's really all we're doing now for the rest of the season. Let's keep going, shall we? But now that Daniel Ricciardo's in the team, it should mean that, you know, we should be able to get into the points quite regularly. Which, if you remember from the previous episode, we're not that far away from McLaren. We're only 8 points behind them. If we can get Daniel Ricciardo just to get in, you know, seventh or eighth for the rest of the season, we've only got, how many races are there left? There's only 4 races left in the season. If we can get 3 points every race from now until the end, we're in with a real chance here. So, look, really, these last few races, we're just trying to wind down the season, aren't we? So I'm going to try and be as quick as ever because I know it's not the most stimulating of videos today. There's not really much to talk about. I hyped it all up like there's this huge dilemma, but quite frankly, there's not really a dilemma. I was always going to sign Daniel Ricciardo. Factory staff are idle, yeah. Daniel was contracted, so he's fully recovered, which is good because you'll remember he was a bit injured. Yeah, we're doing well. We're not going to be signing him anymore. We're not going to be signing him. Yokohama then, so it's a 58-lap race. The lap record's a 138.2. There's likely to be some rain during the race, with Sunday showing a 35% chance. That's interesting because at the moment it's sun, so that may not happen. The corners around the circuit are mostly average speed, so Ferrari should dominate. They've actually not done too badly in the qualifying, Ferrari, but then Mercedes seemed to dominate the race, so that'll be interesting. And the tyre compounds, the super soft, the soft, and the medium. So Ricciardo's already whinging because our car's pretty average. Well, you knew that when you signed. We do have a potential refueling vote coming up. That'll be in the next episode, or the next what's the next? Not the next episode. 25. It'll be in about refueling. We'll have to talk about that a bit later. Pierre Gasly's releasing an album, so his marketability goes up. We do have a bit of a dilemma, though. We found a leak in Danny Kvyat's engine cooling system. The parts reliability will be out of the window if we can't fix it. What should we do? I think we kind of have to fix it, don't we? Because if we have a quick look, where is our engine? Yeah, we've really only got 2 engines, so we don't have a great deal of choice. So it's going to cost us 500k, which is money we could have done without spending. But here we are in Yokohama. How's our scouting going? We've got no one else to scout now, which is good. So we are racing on track A, which doesn't have that. Makes it all like the S's there. It doesn't have that little straight bit, and it's obviously the full circuit. It doesn't have that bit. Medium tyre wear with low fuel burn. So this will be interesting with the tyre wear because I'm really keen to see how Ricciardo steps up. Danny Kvyat struggles a little bit with tyre wear, so let's see him compared to a really, really good driver and see how we go. Low fuel burn, so that means we could probably chop a little bit of the fuel out at the start of the race to really, really help us. And what I'm going to do is I'm thinking I may give all the best parts to Daniel Ricciardo whilst I think of it. Ricciardo has got the best of everything, hasn't he? By the looks of it. Just double check. Yeah, he has, and he's only content. That's a worry. But yeah, so look, everything's, like, weather-wise, clear. There is that 35% chance of rain, but we'll just have to wait and see, and I'll see if it qualifies. I am pretty optimistic about this qualifying session because Daniel Ricciardo is amazing. We did really well. I focused both drivers on one tyre. So Kvyat focused exclusively on the soft tyre and Daniel Ricciardo focused on the super soft tyre. So we managed to max out both the super soft and the soft level 3. Managed to get our qualifying trim and our race trim up to level 3. We've done really, really well. Now, one of the good things actually about Daniel Ricciardo, which I'll show you in a second, Danny Kvyat. Daniel Ricciardo. We're going to go for the super soft and the qualifying trim for obvious reasons. But Kvyat's got this fuel economy, and it's something that I actually forgot about with the push it to the limit as well, which he picked up in the previous episode, where it removes the red zone from car condition. So we probably could have saved the 500,000 from earlier on and used that during the race. But you know, we live and you learn. So fuel economy as well, I think we'll have to use that because this is quite a I am struggling with words today. It's a circuit that you know, really burns through fuel, really chews through it, so we may have to use that. But otherwise, they're both going to be going super soft qualifying for this race. We didn't do too badly for the car setup either, as you can see. Now, there is no rain anticipated, so we should be able to get two stints out of the way. If we have a quick look, as you can see, yeah, so Kvyat focused on the softs, and he's got quite a few super softs there, whereas Ricciardo, he's only got three sets, so he's only going to have one spare set for the race, which we will have to factor in should it require it. Rather interestingly though, Danny Kvyat came in P15, which is, you know, pretty bog standard, isn't it? But Ricciardo, looking on my notes here, came in P8, which is amazing stuff. So if he can finish sort of P8 all the time, then, you know, we could really close down on McLaren and potentially finish P7 for the season, which would be great for the Constructors' Championship. So we'll just leave a little bit of a delay before we send out Daniel Ricciardo. Now, what I may do is I may even send him on a banker lap on some used softs, super softs, just because I think it would be beneficial in the race, because I think we may be using those super softs. If that rain comes down, those super softs are going to be really, really important. So we'll focus on Kvyat for now before we cut to Ricciardo for his lap. Interestingly, though, for the McLaren, Alonso was 17th, Button was 19th. So we only need to score 8 points, man. That's all we need, and we've got a real opportunity of nabbing McLaren at the end. Now, Kvyat's absolutely nailed his setup as he rounds that final right-hander to start his flying lap. Daniel Ricciardo, what can he do? He's got perfect tyre temperatures, but he's overheated his brakes. Now, I'm not expecting Ricciardo to have a very good lap here, because he is on very, very worn super soft. So you can expect to see Kvyat coming out ahead of Ricciardo. Now, Kvyat's got a little bit of traffic. I don't know who that is. Is that a Haas next to him? It looks like it might be. It looks like a Haas. Or is it a Williams? I don't even know. It's a white car, and it's right behind him, so it's causing him a little bit of grief, as Ricciardo's really, really off the pace, which I kind of expected on those super softs. Expect Hamilton. Hamilton's doing very, very well, as Bottas has gone purple in that first sector. So Kvyat's going to be the first to cross the line. There he goes there with a 1:11 dead. Now, expect to see that being beaten. Ricciardo's actually up on his time as Hamilton goes pole with a 1:09.7. Ricciardo is 0.3 quicker than Kvyat on used soft, super soft tyres. How does that work? I've got absolutely no idea. So we will send them out again, and I'll send them out in the same order. I will send Kvyat out first, then I'll send out Ricciardo, because, of course, we don't have to worry about cars, you know, potentially crashing and bringing out a safety car, yellow flag, or even a red flag for that matter. Now, keep an eye on Alonso and Button, who are way off the pace. Like, I mean, Alonso's the best of the rest, really, and he's 0.4 down on Kvyat, and Ricciardo's 0.3 ahead of Kvyat, so that looks really, really well. Ricciardo's doing fantastically well on used super soft tyres. Look at the difference. His tyres are so worn, and yet he's currently sitting in P7. Hopefully he improves on that, as Massa and Hülkenberg have just posted stonking laps as well. So Ricciardo drops down to P9. Now, it takes a minute 30 to get around this circuit, so we will be able to speed things up just a touch, because everyone's on their in lap now. They're just able to go out again right at the end of the session. Weather's pretty much the same. It's very, very hot here. So, come on, let's just speed things up a little bit. I'm really, really optimistic, though. I'm really optimistic that Ricciardo can finish a lot higher than ninth. I'm hoping if he can get sort of seventh, something like that, that'd be incredible stuff. So, here we go. So, we've got 2 minutes to go now. So, now we're going to send out Kvyat, and we'll send him out on fresh super softs. And around a minute 40 is when we will... In fact, I'm going to chicken out. I'm going to go a minute 45. We'll send out Ricciardo, and hopefully... There you go. We'll do it now. And we'll send him out on some fresh, super soft tyres with a lot of track grip, no water on track. There, we're going to focus on Ricciardo, actually, because he's the one that we're going to be watching. And hopefully there's no traffic around him, as it looks like Hülkenberg and Sainz, that's their in-laps there. That was Hülkenberg who passed us there. So they will be diving into the pit. So Ricciardo's going to have nice, clean track ahead of him by the looks of things. Who is that? Yeah, it's Hülkenberg that's ahead. Then there's Perez. So Perez is on his flying lap at the moment. So we may get a little bit of traffic here right at the end. Now Ricciardo needs to go past us. Kvyat's done perfect for both, yet again, for both his brakes and tyres. As Ricciardo's got a little bit of a gap from Perez. So hopefully Perez doesn't hold him up too much. Ricciardo, perfect, perfect. This is much better. This is where we are. So keep an eye on Kvyat. He's 6 tenths down already on his first sector. But that's from Vettel, who's got provisional pole with a 109.2 at the moment. Keep an eye on Ricciardo, though. As long as he's under that 0.6 from the first sector, will be pretty good. He's 0.4, so he's 2 tenths up on Kvyat already. He's down in P11, Ricciardo. But he's the only man, he's the last man on the track. Kvyat's ahead of him. Kvyat's 1 second behind now, so expect to see him up around here, 10th, 11th, 12th, maybe. Ricciardo's got a little bit of traffic. Kvyat doesn't improve. He is P15 for the race. What can Ricciardo do? He's only 8 tenths down here. He could be a lot higher up. He could be P7, P8. Where is he? He is P9. Excellent stuff. And that's his replacement. He's right. He's going to start behind his replacement, Vachon. That's who Red Bull have picked up. I'm guessing he was the reserve driver for them. But he will start just behind him, not by much, but he starts in P9 on a pretty torrid Toro Rosso with Sebastian Vettel yet again leading from pole. Not bad, eh? I'm really, really optimistic. I'm really optimistic with that. P9's good. It shows the difference in the quality from Ricciardo to Kvyat, doesn't it? Let's be real here. Alonso and Button, then, they're 18th and 19th. They are just dropping like stones at the moment. Grosjean and Webber seem to be like improving a little bit. Maybe Haas are, you know, just trying to guarantee an extra point or two to save them from, you know, any sort of potential threat of relegation. Rapac's team are the ones that are bottom at the moment, but they're on the same points as Haas, so they, you know, Haas aren't particularly safe. We're well and truly safe, and we're gunning down McLaren, so you'll have to tune in for that tomorrow. You know the drill. Thumbs up. See you tomorrow for the race. Go Ricciardo. Go me. Subscribe. Cool.